My first memories are of mail. By the age of 7, I knew just what I wanted. I would be the world's best mailman ever. Mail itself, the pure, raw, physical beauty of mail. That's what attracted me to the job in the first place. But over the years, it became much, much more complex.
Mailman.
To get going, I'm going to be late.
We need to talk, Dave.
I don't want to be late, please. My record.
Dave, if you tell me one more time about your perfect record.
It means something to me that I have a perfect record. It means something to the Postal Service.
Dave, I'm not trying to sabotage your perfect delivery record.
It's always on my way out the door that you want to talk. I'd like to talk now, too, if I didn't have my route. How can I talk when I have to do my route?
Just go do your fucking route.
She didn't understand about my route. She didn't understand I was riding a wave. 5 years of perfection. I was like Hank Aaron or Wayne Gretzky, a breaker of records, a champion.
Hi, Mrs. Conkey.
Hi, Dave. Right on time as usual.
You bet. Have a nice day, Mrs. Conkey.
Thank you, Dave.
I never delivered a letter to the wrong address. Never once was late. It's because I concentrate. As an exotic dancer, Denise didn't realize the precision my work required. I tried to tell her, please be careful. Please don't disturb me.
Dave?
Yes?
Can we talk for a minute?
I'm thinking about tomorrow.
What about tomorrow?
About the route.
But Dave, it's the same every day.
That is not true. That is just not true. That's where the other carriers get lulled into a false sense of security. It's different every day. Every day brings with it a new set of problems, and if you're prepared, a new set of solutions.
Dave, we have to leave this town.
What?
I hate this town, Dave. Please, we have to leave this town. You can get a transfer from the Postal Service. You have a perfect record.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What do you think happens to a perfect record when you request a transfer?
I don't know.
It's not a perfect record anymore because it notes on your record that you requested a transfer.
I don't care. I want out. Look. Look outside, Dave. There's nothing out there but desert.
That's where you're wrong. There are houses with people inside them waiting for their mail.
Why can't you get a transfer to Bakersfield at least? I could get another dancing job in Bakersfield. It would be more challenging for you, more mail.
I don't want more challenging. I don't want more mail. I want this here. What I have here is what I want. You don't seem to understand that if I do certain things, I will no longer have a perfect record.
I understand that. I do. But what is the point of having a perfect record if you don't get anything out of it?
I need to spend some time preparing for tomorrow. Could I have some time, please, to prepare for tomorrow? The next day, I felt a little tense. It was because I didn't have time to really relax and think about the route. And then I understood. Denise could be participating in some sort of test of my endurance for the Postal Service. I decided I would have to hang tough, to really bear down. I would work twice as hard at my route until the Postal Service eased up on me, and I would be wary of any tricks.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, I do.
I don't think you do.
You're saying you have to leave.
Right! I'm leaving you!
I don't understand why.
Dave, how could you not understand why?
I still have a perfect record.
Dave, nobody cares.
How do you mean?
Nobody cares about your perfect goddamn record with the Postal Service.
That's not true.
It is true.
Even if you don't care, the Postal Service cares. You can't speak for the Postal Service.
I've got the car loaded. I just need my thermos.
Left me, but took my coffee with her. I make an excellent cup of coffee. Very strong, but not bitter. She took my coffee on the road, and she enjoyed it, never thinking about the fact that she might never taste it again. Denise cannot make coffee.
I didn't hear from Dave.
I didn't hear from Denise.
I got a job dancing in Bakersfield. Sometimes I would miss him, his uniform, his coffee.
The garden went to pieces.
Then I read that little article in the newspaper.
I was beginning to think that maybe it was not a test conducted by the Postal Service.
I've been asking myself, would I have noticed if it wasn't about Dave? Would I have thought twice about how unusual it was?
Then I started to think maybe they didn't care. What if the Postal Service really didn't care? I began to test them in the smallest of ways.
But it was so much mail.
The garden had gone to pot. I dug it up with this.